guys, we are back again, and today what are we making, ma?
We are making keema matar.
Great, we are making chicken keema and matar. It's a very tasty dish. We hope you enjoy it.
Now I have already put the oil, that is about 4 teaspoons of white oil and a little bit of ghee. It gives a good taste, and I've heated it up. Now this is whole spice, this is cardamom, there are black peppers, cinnamon, and some
Can you show the bowl, ma? We can see.
Yeah, okay, I'll show you the bowl. Can you see it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So here is the bowl. It has, can you quickly tell
cinnamon,
me?
Cardamom, then black pepper.
Mm-hmm. Cinnamon, cardamom, black pepper.
And clove.
And clove.
Just okay. A few each.
Great.
I put that into the oil when it's hot.
Okay. What did we have in the oil? Just oil?
I just had white oil, about 4 teaspoon, and about 2 teaspoon of ghee. Now this I have chopped up. That is about 4 medium-sized onions,
mm-hmm.
2 green chili, 10 pods of garlic, and an inch of ginger.
Okay, great.
So that we just have to fry it. This will take a little time. I will add a little salt to it. Then it fries up a little faster. Now I will just start putting my masalas one by one. This is the coriander powder that I'm putting in. About 1.5 teaspoon I've put in. One teaspoon of haldi I've put in. You just fry up everything with this only. Half teaspoon of chili powder. Now that depends on how spicy you want it. I will put 1.5 teaspoons of salt. You put the garam masala at the end, not now.
Let me know if you need something.
Yes. This needs to be fried up nicely.
So about 2-3 minutes of frying?
No, this requires about 5 minutes of frying.
Okay.
The onions, you know, they should not be raw. We need to fry up nicely.
Okay. So around 5 minutes you need to cook this.
Thank you. Now you can understand, you will see the oil floating on top, so you know it's sort of fried. Okay, then you put in your tomatoes that you can puree it or chop it. I've chopped it very fine.
We have finely chopped tomatoes that we added. You can also puree it. I'm trying to get you a closer shot here.
Now the tomato releases some water, but it's okay because you know the keema is there, so that needs to cook a little. Now this is 500 grams of chicken keema.
Okay.
You can use mutton also. We like to keep it a little healthy. So we are using chicken keema and just fry it up a little.
So guys, in terms of using non-vegetarian stuff like this chicken keema and all, you have to make sure that you fried and cooked it for some time, otherwise there's a rawness and a smell that you won't like while eating. So make sure you've cooked it properly for some time.
Now just fry this up a little with the masalas that is there.
How much time does this take in general?
This will take about another 5 minutes.
Okay.
And once you know it, when all the chicken has, you know, turned white, more or less changed the color.
The color changes from pinkish to it'll become whitish.
Yes. Okay, the chicken is mostly turned colored. Now I will put my frozen peas into it. Just see that you remove most of the water from it. Frozen peas usually has, but if you have a little, it's okay. It helps in cooking. So it's more or less okay.
And if by chance you do see there's a lot of water, just dry it up a little bit.
Yes, you have to
evaporate. There's a little bit of gas wastage though. So it's best if you just remove the water before you put it into the food. So the yellow and green is looking very nice because of the contrast. One of the reasons why keema mutter go very well.
Yes, it gives a very good color.
We can even add a little bit of coriander leaves.
That's in the end we will do that.
So we are
right at the end we will do that.
That's optional.
Now we'll just cover it for a little while so that it requires a little bit of cooking.
I think there is some white portion that needs cooking, that's right.
That will get cooked. I'll cover it a little. So this takes a little time. Just cover it a little.
Okay. So in the meantime, could you tell us something about keema mutter?
Keema mutter is a very famous dish from the
north. I'll just focus on you first. Let's know a little about this dish today.
This keema mutter is a very famous dish from the north. Usually in the dhabas and all you get it. Of course it's much richer in the dhabas. But at home you don't need to make it so rich. And if you like, at the end to get that dhaba feel, you know, you can just put in a little bit of kasuri methi and butter. So,
okay. If you, you know, wanted to rich like the dhaba, then you can just add in those few ingredients to make it rich and nice.
I just added a little ghee, that's all, to give it a good flavor. But butter I will not add. Dhaniya patta I will put, kasuri methi I am not putting.
Today the style that we are making is very homely. But you could just add in those few ingredients and make it dhaba style. And you know, maybe for a party, that would be a better choice.
Yes. But and another thing is, this needs to be a little on the dry side to give it more taste.
Okay. So not like
and when you're serving, you can serve with a little bit of lime. Some people like it with a little bit of lime, you can serve it.
So lime is a nice, if you like a little bit of sour, so just add a little bit of lime, it'll be nice.
And you serve it with roti, chapati, tandoori roti, naan. Paratha, naan, anything.
Lachha paratha.
Anything. Even with a bun, it goes very well. Even
as
with
a
bun.
Bread bun.
Yes, yes. Pav bun you get, that also goes very well.
Okay, so just put a little bit of butter and just thoda sa fry and it'll be great. We're done. We should be back.
No, just have some water, so we have to...
We'll wait for a little more time.
Yes, we need to dry that up.
What are the other easy famous dishes with chicken keema that you can do? So chicken keema is a form of chicken that allows us to cook quickly versus other
I will show you that also later on. Keema capsicum also is a very tasty. It's a very very tasty dish.
And you can just use three colors in the capsicum and it looks beautiful.
It looks very nice. Yeah. I'll leave it a little open, let it dry.
It's also
up
a very easy recipe. We'll probably be covering it sometime. Minced chicken is generally an easy form to cook.
It goes fast. It cooks
fast. It is faster than your normal sized chicken, so it's a good option actually. We're still trying to dry out the water.
Yes, this will take little time, you know, especially when it's, if it's fresh peas, this does not happen, but with frozen peas, you have some water retention there, so that takes a little time. Now see, it's more or less, you know, dry and the oil has to show, like when you understand it's more or less dry.
I'll try to give you a closer look of how this looks.
I'll put 1 teaspoon of garam masala.
Okay, 1 teaspoon of garam masala we added. Smells great. You can't transfer the smell through the camera, but it's nice.
The end, I put in 1 squeezed lime juice. That of course depends on your taste, but usually it's tasty when you put it.
That's a little bit of flavor, sour in it. We didn't add any other sour ingredient as well. So this will add a little bit of sour taste.
And
nice.
Then in the end, I put in the
coriander leaves. We'll have to cook for another minute with the coriander leaves and
that's it. There's nothing more to it. And now we are ready to serve it.
Okay.
Great. Switching out the gas. Have a look at it.
So that's our ready keema, and we'll show it to you in the bowl. Let me see if I can get a closer look at it. There. There you go. Fine. Hey guys, we hope you liked today's recipe. Do let us know what you'd like to see more and how you found today's recipe. Do try it and eat it and let us know. Subscribe and see you next weekend. Bye-bye.
Bye.